बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन टू बायोलॉजी इन विच वी स्टडीड अबाउट लाइफ बायोलॉजी एंड द वर्ड्स थ्रू विच बायोलॉजी वर्ड इज डिराइव्ड। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट ब्रांचेस ऑफ बायोलॉजी। In this video, we will discuss about branches of biology, and we also discuss about relationship of biology with other sciences. So first of all, we are going to know about the names of these branches. So one of them is morphology, histology, physiology, cell biology, molecular biology, genetics, embryology, taxonomy, paleontology, environmental biology, parasitology, sociobiology, biotechnology, immunology, entomology, and pharmacology. So these are the branches of biology. Now we are going to study them in detail. So first of all, morphology. The word morphology is derived from a word morph, which means structure, external structure, or the structure which can be seen by naked eye, structure or form. So morphology is the branch of biology in which we study about external structure and form of any living organism. So what is structure? Structure means any part of living organism which can be seen by naked eye or with microscope. We can say that any part of living organism is called structure. Second one is histology. Histology is the study of tissues. Tissues are those structures which are formed by cells. Different cells having same functions unite and form tissues. Next branch is anatomy. Anatomy is totally opposite to morphology. In morphology, we study about external structure, while in anatomy, we study of internal structure of tissues and organs. In anatomy, we discuss about the structure of tissues, the formation of tissues, and which blocks are responsible for formation of tissues and organs. Next branch is Physiology is the branch in which we study about different parts of a living organism, and all the functions happening in living organisms are studied in physiology, like photosynthesis, like respiration, like ATP synthesis, etc. Cell biology is also called cytology, which is derived from cytoplasm. Cell biology is the branch of biology in which we study about cell and organelles. You people know that all type of living organisms are made with one or more than one cells, and the cells are formed by different types of organelles. So the branch of biology in which we study about cell and organelles are called cell biology. Next branch is molecular biology. It's a branch in which we study about molecules of life or biomolecules. So these biomolecules are proteins, carbohydrates, and lipids. Molecular biology is the branch of biology in which study about those molecules through which life is formed, which are responsible for formation of life. Genetics. Genetics is the study of inheritance. So what is inheritance? Inheritance means transmission of characters from one generation to another generation. Inheritance is a characteristics of a living organism through which a living organism transmits its characters to its offspring. This is called inheritance. So the branch of biology in which we study about inheritance is called genetics. Next is embryology. The word is derived from embryo. So first of all, we study about embryology. Study of developing embryo from an egg, a fertilized egg. When a fertilized egg develops into embryo, so this study is called embryology. Taxonomy. Taxonomy is the branch of biology in which we study about naming, classification, grouping of living organisms into groups and subgroups. We people know that there are millions of living organisms, different types of living organisms in world. So it is not easy to know all about them. So scientists keep these living organisms into groups and subgroups. So the branch of biology will deal with the study of naming and classification of living organisms is called taxonomy. Paleontology. Paleontology is the study of fossils. Fossils. What are fossils? Fossils are remains of dead organisms which are buried under ground, like dinosaurs, like different types of fish, like different types of reptiles. So when we study about these fossils, this is called paleontology. Environmental biology. This is also called ecology, and the word is derived from ecosystem. The study of surrounding, in short, study of environment and interactions of environment with environment. When we study about our environment and the interactions of a living organism with our environment is called environmental biology. These interactions may be positive, these interactions may be negative. So in environmental biology, we discussed about how a living organism is related with his environment. Parasitology. Parasitology is the study of parasites. In this branch of biology, we study about the disease-causing agents and living organisms like bacteria, like virus, like fungi, and like some algae. Sociobiology. Sociobiology is the branch of biology in which we study about social behavior of animals. Different organisms, different animals show social behavior like honeybees, like ants, like silkworm. So study about social behavior of these animals is called sociobiology. Biotechnology. It's a latest branch of biology in which we study about the use of living organisms to make substances for human benefits. Different organisms play a role in manufacturing of different useful substances, like some bacteria produce vaccines, like some fungi makes other beneficial products. So in this branch of biology, we discuss about all about these organisms. Immunology. It is related with immune system. Immune system is a natural system in bodies of living organisms which defend against the microscopes, the microorganisms like bacteria, fungi, virus, the disease causing agents. So when we study about immune system, this is called immunology. Entomology. Entomology is the study of insects. You know that there are highest numbers of insects in all living organisms are present in world. So when we study about these insects, in which we study the structure, function, form, reproduction about these insects, this is called entomology. And the last one is pharmacology. Pharmacology is the branch in which we discuss about pharmacy. Mean study of medicines and drugs, the life-saving drugs and medicine. When we study about these drugs and medicine, this is called pharmacology. Now we are going to talk about what is the relationship of biology to other sciences. How biology is related with other sciences? First of all, we study about which senses by which biology is related. First of all, biochemistry, then biophysics, bioeconomics, biogeography, biomathematics or biometry. So now we are going to study them in detail. Biochemistry. There are many chemical reactions happening in living organism, like photosynthesis, like respiration, like translation, transcription, etc. Protein synthesis. So when we study about these reactions and the chemical composition of living organism, so this is a relationship of biology with chemistry. I repeat, when we study about the reactions and the chemical composition, the atoms, the molecules, the elements which form structure of biomolecules or structure of living organism, so this is a relationship of biology with chemistry. This is called biochemistry. Biophysics. Biophysics is a relationship of biology in which we study about how principle of physics is applied to biology, like movement of bone is same like the movement of liver, and the movement of joints is also same like movement of liver. So this is called biophysics. Bioeconomics. This is our relationship of biology in which we see the living organisms in economic point of view. We deal with organisms in economic point of view. How economically living organisms are important, like different plants are economically important, agriculture and different type of living organism animals which are backbone of economy of a living organism of a country. This is called bioeconomics. Biogeography. Geo means earth and graphy mean yani ki metri. In biogeography, we study about how living organisms are distributed in different parts of the world. You people know that in different parts of the world, the type of living organisms are somehow different, and their modes, their structure are somehow different. So, but in biogeography, we see about the different distributions of living organism in different parts of world. Biomathematics. In biology, we also use mathematical data to research in biological research. In other words, so when we apply mathematical techniques to analyze data in biology, this is called biomathematics. In biology, different researches are carried. So there is a need of mathematical techniques. So when mathematical techniques are applied to biology, this is called biomathematics. So this was all about the relationship of biology, the branches of biology. I request again to all of you to subscribe my channel, to like the video, and to share it with your friends. Allah Hafiz.